So we are seeing the age fill algorithm. So age fill algorithm means what? One by one edges we are going to fill it up. So now see, this is the polygon which has been shown. Okay, this is one object, and that we have to fill it by a color. So if you see the first image, the object is not filled with any color. Okay, so one by one we have to fill the object with a solid color. So now the aim of this edge fill algorithm is, for each scan line intersecting a polygon edge at x1, y1, complement all the pixels whose midpoint lie to the right of x1, y1. So now see, what is this? So first diagram we will consider. Okay. Now in the first diagram, the first diagram is only showing the object, okay, having points P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Now the second diagram, see the second diagram. In the second diagram, consider the edge P2 and P3. Consider the edge P2 and P3. See, the rightmost edge is P2 and P3. Okay. Now this edge we have to consider, and the right side of the edge, we have to fill it with a color. Now we know the tagline for the edge fill algorithm is, for each scan, see this edge fill algorithm, for each scan line intersecting a polygon edge at x1, y1, complement all the pixels whose midpoint lie to the right of x1, y1. Okay, so now this is the what edge fill algorithm says. We have to complement all the pixels whose midpoint lie to the right of x1, y1. x1, y1 means our edge. So now in this case, our edge is P2 and P3. So we have to scan the pixels whose midpoint lies to the right of the edges. So now, as we are considering the P2 and P3, so see, the pixels rightmost to that edge, we have to make it colored. So see, if you see this, see, edge we have considered P2 and P3, and the right side of the P2 and P3 is filled with color. Okay, getting? So the simple technique for the edge fill algorithm is, consider the edge and fill the right side of the edge with color. That means the right side pixels of the edge will be filled with color. Now consider the second pixel, P3 and P4. So see, P3 and P4, this is my P3 and P4 pixel. See, in the first block, first diagram, P4, P3. Similarly, now see the third diagram, P3, P4. Now P3, P4, considering the edge P3, P4. Now from that P3, P4, I want to consider the rightmost pixel and make them color. So when I consider the rightmost pixel, see, when I consider the rightmost pixel, this is my edge, right? This is my edge, P3, P4. Now consider the right side pixels. Now only consider this portion, okay, because my edge is only at the, only this much is my edge. So consider the rightmost portion of the edge. Now see, when I consider the rightmost portion of the edge, the pixels which are inside that object are filled with color, and the outside was already colored. If you see the previous diagram, we had already filled the pixels with color. So now what we will be doing, we will be making that pixels white, because we have already filled with the colors. And रूल कसा आहे आपला की ते पिक्सेल्स जे काय कन्सिडर केलेत, वी हॅव टू मेक देम कॉम्प्लिमेंट. सो दिस पिक्सेल्स विच आर ऑलरेडी फिल्ड विथ कलर, नाव दे टर्न टू व्हाईट, अँड द पिक्सेल्स विच आर नॉट फिल्ड विथ कलर, दे आर फिल्ड विथ कलर. सो वॉट वी हॅव कन्सिडर, वी हॅव कन्सिडर दिस edge, this is my edge P4 and P3. Now what I want to do, I want to make all the pixels राइट मोस्ट टू दैट एज. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू कंसिडर ऑल द पिक्सेल्स राइट मोस्ट टू दैट एज. सो दिस आर माई पिक्सेल्स राइट मोस्ट टू P4 एंड P3, P4 एंड P3. सो नाउ सी, ऑलरेडी सम पिक्सेल्स वेर फिल्ड विथ कलर एंड सम पिक्सेल्स वेर नॉट फिल्ड विथ कलर. सो दोज पिक्सेल्स विच आर फिल्ड विथ कलर, आई विल मेक देम व्हाइट अगेन. ओके, दैट मीन्स आई विल रिमूव देयर कलर. एंड द पिक्सेल्स विच आर नॉट फिल्ड विथ कलर, आई विल फिल अप देम. सो दिस इज वॉट वी हैव कंसिडर द एज P4 एंड P3. सो आफ्टर कंसिडरिंग द एज P4 एंड P3, दिस विल बी माई डायग्राम. सी, दिस इज माई डायग्राम फॉर कंसिडरिंग द एज P3 एंड P4. ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड विद द नेक्स्ट एज. ओके, नाउ कंसिडर द एज P4 एंड P5. तो सी विच इज द एज P4 एंड P5. सो दिस इज माई एज P4 एंड P5. नाउ सी द पिक्सेल्स विच आर टू द राइट मोस्ट ऑफ दैट एज. नाउ कंसिडर द पिक्सेल्स विच आर टू द राइट मोस्ट ऑफ दैट एज. सो विच आर दोज पिक्सेल्स? सो सी हियर, दीज आर द पिक्सेल्स. ओके, सी आई एम आउटलाइनिंग इट. सो माई दीज आर द पिक्सेल्स विच कम्स अंडर दिस एज, मीन्स दीज आर द पिक्सेल्स विच आर राइट मोस्ट टू माई एज P4 एंड P5. So these are my pixels which are to the rightmost to my edge P4 and P5. So see now some pixels which in see the previous diagram. From the previous diagram we will consider the next image. Okay, so see the previous diagram. In the previous diagram some pixels were already filled with color and some pixels were not filled with color. So see these pixels are not filled with color, and but the inside pixels are filled with color. So opposite of this will happen. Inside pixels will become white and the outside pixel of that image will become colored. Okay, so let me show you again. Please pay attention. I have considered this edge. Okay, I have considered this edge. Now this edge is my P4 and P5. Now I want to consider the pixels right most to that edge. So which are those pixels? See I am drawing this. So these are my pixels right most to the edge P4 and P5. Now I want to fill that pixels. So when I want to fill these pixels, see the previous diagram. Now in the previous diagram, see, consider this. Okay, and this is my edge of P4 and P5. This is my edge of P4 and P5. Now see in the diagram, those pixels which are considered as white, make them colored, and the pixel which are filled with color, make them white. So this is how my edge P4 P5 diagram looks like after completing filling these pixels. So those pixels which are covered colored, make them white, and the pixels which are not colored, make them colored. Okay, so now consider the next pixel P5 and P1. So let's consider the next edge, that is P5 and P1. So you see, this is my edge P5 and P1. Okay, this is my edge P5 and P1. So when we consider the edge P5 and P1, now consider the rightmost pixel of edge P5 and P1. Now, which are the rightmost pixel of edge P5 and P1? See. So these are the pixels. Okay, these are the pixels rightmost to edge P5, P1. Now what I want to do is I want to again make the pixels colored which are not colored. So if you see in the middle of the object, so see this part is white. Okay, this part is white. Now I want to make this part colored. So when I will make this part color, see here, this part get colored. Okay, and the rest of the part, means this part is already filled with color. So now I want to, this whole part is already filled with color. These pixels are also colored. Okay, see in the previous diagram, these pixels are colored. So now this all pixels will turn white. So if you see, these all pixels are turned white. So this is my simple age fill algorithm. By considering the age of the object, we are filling the whole object. I will repeat from first, see it again. The basic scenario is we have to fill the object with color. Okay, so whatever the object is, I want to make it solid. So the object is already given. It has points P1, P2, P3, P4, and P5. See the first image, P1, P2, P3, and P5. So this is my object. Now the end, if you see the end image, my object is filled with color, right? My object is filled with color. So this is the major scenario of age fill algorithm, where we will be filling the object with a color. So now consider the ages one by one. Now consider the age one by one. So let's consider the age. First, we will consider the age P2 and P3. So this is my age P2 and P3. So if you see the P2 and P3 age in the first diagram, now I want to consider the pixels rightmost to that age. So which pixels are rightmost to that age? See, these are the pixels which are rightmost to that age. So those pixels which are rightmost to the age P2 and P3, I want to make them filled with color. So in the next diagram, see, these pixels are filled with color. Okay. So these pixels are now filled with color. So as we have considered the age P2, P3, the right side of the age are filled with color. Now next, consider the age P3, P4. So let's consider the age P3, P4. Now see which is the age P3, P4. So this is my age P3, P4. Here also this is my age P3, P4. Now consider the rightmost part of the age P3, P4. The rightmost part of the age P3, P4 will be these pixels. These pixels are my rightmost part. Okay, this means these pixels. Now I want to make the pixels colored which are not colored, and I want to make the pixels colored which are which the pixels which are colored, I want to make them white, and the pixels which are not colored, I want to make them colored. So see here in the diagram, some pixels which were already colored in the previous diagram, see these pixels are already colored. Okay, these pixels are already colored. So here it turned white. See, here it is turned white, and the pixels which are not color, means these pixels now turned into colored. Now this is solid image. Okay, so this is what the age filling algorithm is. Now let's consider the other image, other pixels we will consider. So next age we will consider. Now next age is P4, P5. So see the age P4, P5. So this is my age P4 and P5. Now consider all the rightmost pixel of age P4, P5. Now see in the previous diagram, this is my age P4, P5, and the rightmost pixel of P4, P5 are this, right? These are the pixels, rightmost pixel to the age P4, P5. Now see in the previous diagram and in the new diagram. So in the previous diagram, the pixels which are not colored, means these pixels, okay, these pixels are not colored, right? These are the white pixels. It turns into solidify. See, the white pixels now turned into solidify. See, all these pixels are now solidified. So the pixels which are not filled with color are now filled with color, and the pixels which are already colored is now turned white. So if you see this, these are turned white because these pixels are already colored. Okay. Now consider the next age. So next age is P5 and P1. So let's consider age P5 P1. So see, this is the age P5 and P1. So this here also, this is my age P5 and P1. Now when we consider this age, let me show you. So when we consider the age P5 P1, so see, consider the all this pixels, rightmost pixel to the age P5 P1. So the pixels rightmost to the P5 P1 are this pixels. Okay, these are the pixels rightmost to the age P5 P1. So when we are considering the rightmost pixel of age P5 and P1, now see the pixels which are already colored. If you see the previous diagram, means this image. Now in this image, see the pixels which are colored, they are now turned into white, and the pixels which are not colored, they are now turned into colored. That means they are solidified now. Okay, so see the last image. So if you see this image, last image. Now see the difference between the first image and the last image. Now the first image, the object was not filled with any color, it was not solidified. But if you see the last image, the image is now solidified. So this is the age fill algorithm. We are considering the age and filling up the rightmost pixel of that age. So this is my age fill algorithm. But in this age fill algorithm, there is one disadvantage. Disadvantage is, if you see, some of the pixels are not colored. If you see this series, these pixels are not colored. If you see the pixels, these pixels are not colored, right? Some pixels are not colored. See, this pixel is also not colored. This pixel is not colored. Even these pixels are not colored. So this is one disadvantage of the age fill algorithm, where all the pixels not get filled properly. So if you see the first image and the last image, in the first image C and last image C, some pixels are empty, means they are not filled with color, and some pixels are cross the outline of the object. So this is one disadvantage of the age fill algorithm. So this disadvantage is covered with the fence fill algorithm. So now let me tell you what is the fence fill algorithm. So in the fence fill algorithm, what we do, I will show you the diagram. So see the fence fill algorithm, which clears the drawback of edge fill algorithm. Now the fence fill algorithm, for each scan line intersecting a polygon edge, if the intersection is to the left of the fence, complement all pixels having a midpoint to the right of the intersection of the scan line and the edge, and to the left of the fence. And if the intersection is to the right of the fence, complement all the pixels having a midpoint to the right of or the intersection of the scan line and edge, and the right of the fence. So what does this means? So see this diagram. In this diagram, fence means what? The intersection line is drawn. Okay, see, the intersection is line is drawn in between. So this is called as fence. Okay, the intersection line is called as fence. So now, the intersection is to the left of the a midpoint to the right of the intersection of the scan line and the edge and to the left of the fins. Now see, the intersection is left of the fins. So now let's see. Now consider the edge P2 and P3. So when we consider the edge P2 and P3, now this is my edge P2 and P3, and this is my fins. Okay, this is my fins. Now what we say, if the intersection is to the left of the fins, so if the whatever the intersection will be, okay, so whatever the intersection will be, that will all complement a pixel having a midpoint to the right of the intersection, having a midpoint to the right of the intersection. This means you have to consider only the area between the fins and the edge. So the area between the fins and the edge is this. So this is my area between the fins and the edge. Okay, now only consider this area and make them colored. So the pixels which are not colored, make them colored. That means complement it. When we say the image is colored, we in the binary form we use 1 and 0 when the image is not colored. So now here in this case image is colored, so we will make them color. See in the next diagram, all the area between the fence and the edge is colored. So now consider the next edge, that is P3, P4. Now see, this is my edge P3 and P4. This is my edge P3 and P4. Now see, this is the edge P3 and P4. Now what we have to do, we have to, again, the pixels which are right to the fins and the pixels which are leftmost to the edge, consider that pixels. Now let me show you. This is my edge. Again, there is my fence. Now the pixels rightmost to the fence. This means these are my pixels. Okay, these are my pixels. And the pixels rightmost to the edge. So these are my pixels. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to only consider the one. Okay. So the pixels which are rightmost to the fence, we will make them complement. So if you see the pixels which are rightmost to the fins are now already filled with color. I have made them zero. That means I have made them white. Okay, so this is my fins and this is my edge. So the pixels in between I have made them white. Now consider the next image. See here the edge P4 and P5 is considered. So if you see the edge P4 and P5, so this is my edge P4 and P5, and there is a fence. Okay, there is my fence. So what we have to do, if the intersection is to the right of the fence, complement all the pixels having midpoint to the left. If the intersection, see here, see, please screenshot this. This is very important. What it says, if the intersection is the left of the fins, then complement all the pixels from the right. Now, if the intersection is to the right of the fins, complement all pixels having midpoint to the left. So see, now my intersection is to the, now tell me this P4, P5. So this P4, P5, it lies to the left of the fins or right of the fins. Yes, this, if you see the edge P4, 5, this edge lies to the left of the fins. So see, if the edge is lying to the left of the fins, see what it says. If the intersection is to the left of the fins, complement all pixels having a midpoint to the right. Having a midpoint to a right. So when we consider the edge P4 and P5, and this is my fence. Now we have to complement the pixels to the right of the edge. So what are the edge? What are the pixels from the right of the edge? So if you see, these are my pixels. Okay, so these are my pixels in between the fence and the edge. So these are my rightmost pixels. So I want to now complement these pixels. So see in the figure. So these pixels are now got filled with a color. Okay. Similarly, see the edge P5 and P1. So if you consider this edge P5, P1, and my fence is here. Now the edge is lying to the left side of the fence. So if the edge is lying to the left side of the fence, we have to consider the rightmost image. And if the edge is lying to the right side of the fence, then we have to consider the leftmost pixels. You see, this is very easy and simple. If the edge is lying to the left of the fence, then we will be considering the pixels from right side of the edge. And if the edge is lying to the right side of the fence, then we will be considering the pixels from the left side of the edge till the fence. So now my edge is at P5 and P1. So as my edge is at P5 and P1, so now consider the pixels from right side. Okay, as I said, the edge is at the left side of the fence, so consider the rightmost pixels. So now I will consider these pixels, okay, in the pixels between the fence and the edge. So these are my pixels. So if you see the previous diagram, in the previous diagram, some part is already filled with color. Now that will turn to white, okay, and the part which is not filled with color, that will turn to the solidified. That means it will be colored. So see the first image and the next image. Yeah, that means last image. Now this is was my first and this is my second. So this now in this case my first object and second last object is now filled with solid color. So these are the two ways, okay, to for the edge fill algorithm. The first is by only considering the edges and going to the rightmost. Next is by considering the fence technique. Now in the fence only we take an intersection between the object and we consider whether the fence is as left side of the edge or right side of the edge. So if the edge is left side of the fence, then we will be considering the rightmost pixels. And if the edge is to the right side of the fence, then we will be considering the left side of the edge. So this is what the fence fill algorithm is. So the difference between edge fill and a fence fill is only that in the edge fill algorithm, we need to address all the pixels unnecessary. And with the help of this fence fill algorithm, number of pixels addressed by the edge fill algorithm is reduced by introducing a fence. Okay, the number of pixels addressed by the edge fill algorithm is reduced by introducing a fence. So this is what my fence fill algorithm is. So today we have seen the edge fill algorithm and fence fill algorithm. So only difference between the edge fill and scan fill is in the edge fill we need to scan all the pixels unnecessarily, but with the help of the fence technique we only scan the pixels which are in between fence and the edge. Means scan conversion is reduced. Pixel scanning is reduced with the help of this fence technique. This is the only one of the advantage of fence fill algorithm over edge fill algorithm. So I hope you all have understood this edge fill and fence fill algorithm technique.